Hello everybody. So this is my last video in the UK for a while. Tomorrow evening I'm flying home to Rwanda. I've been on hiatus here in the UK for about the past 4 months, seeing my family. I usually get back to see them about once every year and a half to 2 years. And I was just about to book my tickets on the website. I literally had my finger on the book now button when COVID happened. And so, you know, I was just about to book them when the news started to come out. And I thought, you know, I'll give that a week and see what happens. And of course, by the end of that week, the whole world had little red dots across it. We were all in full lockdown. There were no flights coming in or out of Rwanda. So I just had to kick back and wait it out. So I'm back in the UK with family for the first time in over 3 years. So that's been amazing. It really has. And I've had an incredible time. I've been up to the Lake District. I've been on long country walks. I've seen some Christmas lights. I had afternoon tea with my mum at Rushton Hall. So it really has just been a wonderful, wonderful holiday and one that I really needed. And I'm all ready now to get on the plane and go back and see my cats. About 90% of my luggage is actually cat food. Yeah, but anyway, the only other thing I just wanted to look at before I went is the end of a little story that began last September. So I've got some lovely friends. This hat that I'm wearing here was sent to me by my friend Vicky, who knitted it herself, along with a pair of socks, because she was worried that I might not survive the British winter, which is a very, very real concern, unfortunately. You know, in Rwanda, we don't go below about 16, 15 degrees at the worst, whereas, you know, the UK winters can be pretty damn cold. But as it's actually been the warmest winter on record, I think, in the UK this year, for Christmas and Boxing Day. And I mean, it's been incredibly warm here, and I have actually, after the first couple of weeks, I've been fine. So I'm now completely acclimatized to the British weather again, just in time to go back. But thank you, Vicky, and Di, for sending me this lovely hat. And there was one last thing that came through the post that was particularly noteworthy. So, I have a friend, David Southall, who, long story short, created this fabulous kind of artistic landscape for writers and photographers and artists and all forms of creative people. And it's called Hookland. So it's this imaginary county in England where sort of all of the folklore and the mysterious little things that you hear about throughout the British Isles, they kind of collect and pool together in this imaginary county. And anybody can set writing there, anybody can set songs there, anybody can set videos there. You know, it's kind of a creative commons playground of folklore. And I did actually, hold on 1 minute. So yeah, I actually set a novel in Hookland. It's kind of a bit of a paranormal, creepy kind of novel. But this story is to do with something else. He accidentally tweeted about a piece of artwork that somebody did, this beautiful line loom cutting of swans. Now, another book that I wrote, oh, here it is, is The Children of Lear. Sorry, this isn't entirely an advert for my books, but if you do want to buy them, please, you know, go check them out. But, you know, he was thinking his head, you know, I'd written this book, a retelling of The Children of Lear, which is about children that get turned into swans. And he saw the line loom art of the swans. And he accidentally confused us because we both follow Hookland. And he tweeted out that I had done the artwork. And of course I hadn't. It was Maria's artwork. And so me and Maria started to exchange messages. And we did a little art exchange. I sent her a copy of my book, and she sent me some of her artwork. and it arrived back in September-ish. And my mum opened the artwork, and it's beautiful. She sent me a photograph of it and everything. And then she did like the worst possible thing that you can imagine. She put it in a safe place, safe place, safe place. And so I got back round about October, I guess it was, round about. And of course, she searched the whole house. She'd been around the entire house. We both had, and we could not find this piece of artwork. And I was going to tweet about it once I found it, that I'd actually got it. And I couldn't. And then basically, the other day, it suddenly turned up. And so I am opening this for the very, very first time. I've seen a picture of it, but I haven't seen the actual piece of artwork. So this is Maria's art that she sent me. Oh! There's a little message fallen out. Let's see. Oh, she sent me two of her cards as well. Two wolves. Hiya, Mary and Grace. I hope you are well when you finally get to see the spirit badgers. Here's to things getting gentler again. Love and best wishes, Maria. Oh, that's really lovely. She's got beautiful handwriting as well. I wish I had handwriting like this. My handwriting is absolutely illegible, but hers is really pretty. And I'm very well. I'm very well, and I'm receiving this, the spirit badges, just before I'm about to go back again. Oh, wow. Oh, this is beautiful. Let me take it out of the. Let me just gently get it out. Oh, it's really, really beautiful. So this is her piece called the Spirit Badgers. So yeah, that's absolutely beautiful. Thank you, Maria. And I'm going to tweet about this, and I will put a link to her work below if you'd like to check out some more, because she's really, really talented. So yeah, it was just a really nice art exchange that kind of serendipitously came about. So yes, all right, I'm going to leave it there, and I will see you in Rwanda.